Thank goodness. Not everyone's in the field. This is Dr. Yasna reporting. Do you copy? I'm entering the campgrounds. Is anyone out there? Oh, it's just an Androbot. Androbot! Androbot, guide me to the nearest crew member. Androbot, guide two people. Androbot, locate human. Damn! Dr. Gorski, have you made changes to the Androbot's algorithms without telling anyone? Again. Oh, well. Never mind. I've located Dr. Krauter. He's in bad shape. I'm gonna examine him now. Excuse me.
Can you hear me?
Astrogator.
Finally. I've been listening to you for 2 hours now.
My receiver is dead.
No need to explain yourself, Doctor. I know everything. The transmitter was still working, so I heard your reports. Glad you didn't lose your head.
Wait, please. I need to reconnect. Testing. 1, 2, 3.
Copy you, Doctor. Loud and clear, but to the point. As I understand, there's only Dr. Krauter at the camp, and he's not well. What happened to him?
I was just about to examine him. Dr. Krauter, please don't be startled. I need to take your hand. Temperature normal. Pulse too. O2 saturation is fine. There's nothing physically wrong with the doctor. His pupils respond properly. Look at my finger. No delay in reactions.
Yet no response to verbal communication.
None.
Conclusions, Doctor? Do you have any idea what's wrong with him?
Akinesia, mutism, impoverishment of mimic movements, and reaction to stimuli. These are all symptoms of stupor. But it's difficult to pinpoint the cause of the disorder. We need to quickly perform a complete set of tests and focal plane tomography of his brain. Otherwise, I won't be able to say anything more.
I'll prepare the infirmary. But first things first, lander. We need to get you all on board.
Okay. What should I do?
Please look for the mission log. It should include crucial data about the crew's activities. We have three more people to find, and you still need to designate a place for the landing.
Hello? Anyone else here? I found Dr. Krauter. It's not a mission log. Dr. Krauter kept records. Meticulous as always.
What's in there?
Dr. Gorski has moved away from the research sector to the west.
Ah, that's right. You followed those deposits of metal.
The most important thing is probably the landing coordinates. BA2316.
Noting. 316. Excellent. I'm uploading the data. Starting calibration. Are you looking for the detector?
Yeah, just a sec. Got it.
Please make sure it works.
I don't understand why it wouldn't. It's a rather reliable piece of equipment.
Like everything around that's already broke.
Touché, sir. I'm leaving the tent.
All right, now for the robot.
It's unresponsive.
Yes, I know. I'm currently trying to establish connection.
Can I help somehow?
You must look for the others, Doctor. I'll take care of this myself. Get the tin head back on its feet remotely. And secure Krauter. I have everything I need, just...
Is something wrong with the connection, sir?
It's not working. I'm not sure why. There's a relay transmitter in the camp, so the signal should be strong enough.
A relay? Huh.
Yasna? What are you up to?
One sec. I'm looking for it.
What about the rest of the crew? You're gonna make them wait?
Right. The others. No time to lose.
Exactly. All right, you tin bastard. One more time.
Point in going back this way. I'm entering the research area. Clear for now.
Tracker?
Silent. By the way, what did they find here?
Oh, right. You don't remember. A piece of metal sticking out of the ground. Sounds inconspicuous, but in this desert environment, it's a phenomenon. The artifact turned out to be too big to dig up.
It's here. I can see the structure. I'm in the right place.
Understood. Please continue.
Any progress?
Dig as far as the terrain and out. It'll take a while.
Regis, come in. Status report.
Astrogator, sir. We dug up another 3 cubic meters. The object exhibits remarkable structural homogeneity. All spectroscopic analysis shows similar results.
Steel with tungsten and nickel alloy?
That's right. With the addition of other common metals.
Is there any chance of retrieving the entire object for research purposes?
Even sonar couldn't cover the entirety of it. Instead, Dr. Gorski calibrated the detector, so we had a look beneath the surface.
And? What did you see there?
More of the same. What protrudes above the ground is just the tip of the iceberg. We estimate it extends at least 50 meters underground.
I see.
Oh, and furthermore, it's not a single object. Down below, there is an entire root system. So vast that it's impossible to cover it all at once, either with a scanner or a detector.
Have you followed its course?
Dr. Gorski's doing just that.
Gorski, are you scanning those roots?
Affirmative. I'm headed westwards. Been going for a few hundred meters already. Still haven't reached the end of it.
Sorry to interrupt, gentlemen, but I confirm my suspicions. This area has been tectonically inactive for a very long time, and the aeolian activity is minimal. Therefore, the material that has settled on, or rather covered this metallic structure, it's very old, which means these structures are even older.
What are we talking about here? A few thousand years? Tens of thousands?
I can't give a precise assessment, not yet.
I'm asking for a rough estimate, Merritt.
I guess it could be hundreds of thousands, if not millions of years old.
Anything else?
Yes. These structures almost certainly didn't form through natural processes.
Almost?
Well, they don't look like anything I've seen before. And you know I've seen a lot, novik. Also, I can't find any scientific explanation for this form.
Could this be what the Alliance is here for?
Oh, don't let me guess that. I really don't know.
Personally, I doubt it, Astrogator. The more research we do, the more convinced I am that it serves no purpose at all. It's even hard to imagine this would ever have any function.
Regis, come in. I've registered a slight change in the radiation readings.
And now?
The level has significantly increased.
No need to worry, Dr. Yasna. It's just X-rays from the active detector. Our probes are quite sensitive. They record even the slightest change. Can't any comment.
Regis, we're losing reception. Carvel, can you hear us? Merritt, we can't hear you! Merritt!
What now, sir?
We listen. Wait for the interference to pass.
Excuse me, but I don't think it will pass on its own. We need to take action.
What do you suggest?
We need to take action.
What do you suggest?
I can board the second lander and fly to the surface.
Yes, sir, I can't let you go alone. My leg...
I am. Unfortunately alone. Working equipment gave me hope, but someone just abandoned it. Didn't even turn it off.
That is indeed unfortunate. We need to expand our search radius.
Someone, I'm following the signal. Something on the ground. It's a journal. geological cross-section measurements. These are Marit's notes. Oh, she must be somewhere close.
Please search the entire area thoroughly.
See her. The signal's coming from a cast-off backpack.
That's concerning.
She's here, Marit.
Wake up.
Do you hear me?
Dr. Marit?
No vital functions.
What's going on?
To... 1, 2, 3. Come on. 1, 2. Nothing. Don't do this to me, Marit. Don't. Please. Next.
Yes, I think so. It should be close. Do the worst. You'll find the doctor, alive. I'm sure about that.
Someone's here. Oh, no.
Yasna, status. Yasna.
He's... Cobble?
He's also...
Don't do this to me. Oh. You're alive! Did you hear that, sir? Cobble's alive.
I didn't doubt it for a second, Doctor. What's his current state?
Checking. Parameters normal, yet he's completely unresponsive. Koval? Koval? His eyes are so empty. Just like Krauter's. Krovel, what the hell is wrong with you?
Are all the symptoms the same as Dr. Krauter's?
He's calm. Calmer.
Well, at least he's alive. Now listen to me, Yasna. The lander is on its way, but before you get Dr. Krovel on board, I want you to do something. Yasna.
I'm listening.
Please look around for his journal.
It's everywhere. In pieces.
No, not good. Krovel was in radio contact with Dr. Gorski.
Taking notes.
That's exactly why it's so important. These notes may help us find our man.
I'll go over them, but it may take a while.
Have you found it?
No, it's nothing about Dr. Gorski. Found them. Surprisingly accurate. He wrote down Gorski's every step.
Great. Let's get Koval to the evacuation area. Can you carry him, Doctor?
Won't be pretty hard in 1G. But the gravity here should make things a tad easier. Got him.
When you're there, put Dr. Koval in the seat. I'll connect to the astrobot through the lander's antenna.
Haven't you rebooted yet?
No, not quite. But it will work now.
The lander's already descending. Damn. I have a bad feeling. It won't break into pieces, right?
The descent is proceeding smoothly. Don't worry.
Everything's falling apart here. I don't know. Maybe we're dealing with some kind of anomaly. An atmospheric or magnetic phenomenon.
Yeah. Wouldn't something like that show on the charts? All those measurements Gorski took?
I remember. Maybe he made a mistake. Only Gorski's left. He might have made it quite far.
Agreed. Everything points to it.
I don't know how long I'll be looking for him. It might take hours before I come back. It would be best if I followed Gorski right away. But shouldn't I still transfer the others?
No, there's no need. I just regained control of the Androbot, so please leave it to me.
Understood. I'm leaving the excavation site. How did he come down? Sikorsky's signal.
So soon? It's unlikely to be him.
Then who?
Not who, but what. That's weird. Dr. Gorsky.
You were correct, sir. It's just our probe. It looks inactive.
Can't be completely broken if you picked up a signal. I'd say it's running in safe mode. Please try to power it on.
Do we have time for this?
It's for a good reason, Doctor. The probe could prove useful in the search. And besides, you'll see.
Okay. I'm opening the probe. Turning the systems on.
No, no, stop. Wait for my instructions. There's a button on the left side of the fuse box. Hold it, and then turn the dial again. And go ahead.
Slide records?
Correct.
I didn't know we had access to them.
You couldn't have known. This is not standard procedure. But as they say, extremis malis, extrema remedia.
Let's take a look. A photo of the first days on the surface. They started exploring the littoral zone almost immediately.
They reported as much. Wasn't until the fourth day the comms failed.
I recognize these structures. This is where they began to dig. Hours passed. Three crew members are still there. Dr. Gorsky must have left already.
We lost contact shortly thereafter.
The probe followed him, and he followed the detector's readings.
Going after those metal structures.
Yes, that's what I meant.
What's next?
Last slide. There's mostly noise.
Nothing in particular stands out to you, Doctor. They were digging and suddenly, poof, people are dead?
No need to shout, Astrogator. I'm just letting you know what I see. That's all. Hang on. An absurdly high electromagnetic field reading.
That's something. Sort of. What are the earlier readings?
Checking. Still high in the slide just before. And earlier, quite normal. It happened in a matter of seconds. But there's nothing except dunes. Sand, a few rocks, a shadow.
Shadow?
Another sandstorm, I guess.
All right, Doctor. Let's move on. You may turn on the fuses now. We'll take the probe with us.